Hi, I'm John Rayfield, and I run Client AI Intel, and I'm going to talk a little bit more about our plans for AI and Client. So just stepping back a second, thinking about cloud, AI is actually a very cloud-centric world today. And, you know, that's got some great, you know, advantages, right? There's massive scalable compute in the cloud, but there's also some challenges, right? One of the challenges is if you think about hundreds of millions of PC users, how does that work for the cloud? How does that scale? Then there's high latency potentially for user interfaces, there's security concerns, and it's a very expensive place to do the compute. So, you know, what we're seeing is there's lots and lots of reasons to migrate more of this across to the client, which is a really different compute model. It's actually massively distributed scale, but it has these advantages of low latency, improved security and privacy, and much lower cost. So we're actually seeing today is sort of two worlds of AI almost. The sort of enhancements to experiences that you've got today. So think of things like video collaboration, for example, where we can enhance that and we can enhance the audio effects behind that. But the sort of brave new world of AI and everything that's going on around us today with generative AI, things like ChatGPT, for example, and other things like Stable Diffusion, these are things that are really going to land moving forwards on the client. As we evolve through this, so these existing experiences that get enhanced, people want to make these experiences better and better. We're seeing significant uplifts in the compute required. So 10x to 50x the compute. And the only way we can do that in platforms is to add a more dedicated inference accelerator. So we really see, you know, just stepping back a little, that Intel's really well positioned to lead this next transition and transformation for the PC. So we're building now, you know, very power efficient platforms with significant inference uplift through the dedicated accelerator. We're actually, you know, leveraging our legacy of x86 apps. And so we want to take all those great innovations in the ecosystem and the software ecosystem with us and really enable the creativity of our developers. And then, of course, this new world of generative AI, we want to unlock that too and have new partners there as well as existing partners. So now just looking at Meteor Lake a little and what we're going to do with Meteor Lake moving forwards. So Meteor Lake launches at the end of this year. It's our first low power platform that includes a dedicated AI accelerator called the VPU. It's across all SKUs of the platform. But one of the key things I just want to say is it's a true heterogeneous compute. So we're actually going to leave AI workloads on all three engines in the platform, which are now the CPU, the GPU, and the VPU. And the VPU has really the characteristic that it's the place to do, you know, lots of inference at very low power. So a big part of this is software and enabling our partners. And in that, we're enabling, you know, fundamentally leveraging Onyx, which is an open AI model standard. We're also got our own tool chain called OpenVINO, which is sort of top to bottom optimization for the stack. And also other pieces like DirectML. And another big piece we've been working on in the space is webm, and that's to enable web-based apps. So in the ecosystem today, we actually have already hundreds of applications on client, and you know, these are already AI enabled to some degree. And moving forwards, we want to take all those partners with us, and we want to enhance those experiences, and we're working with them to do that. And we're going to enable them with the VPU. We're already working on that. And we've got all this tooling and frameworks in place to enable that seamless transition to the VPU. And of course, adding the generative experiences as well. This is going to be existing software partners, but also new software partners with new experiences. So just an example of this is video collaboration, whether it's Zoom, WebEx, Teams, you're going to see improved user experiences in collaboration. And all of this comes about because we can do much more compute at much lower power. Then another big piece that you might have seen actually at the Microsoft Build event very recently is we partnered with Microsoft again on DirectML and Adobe, and we're actually enabling a nice, very clean flow for broad ISV scale with DirectML. So that's a very important piece for us to bring the majority of the software community with us. And then back into the software journey again, and I sort of say this a lot internally, is, you know, this AI space is really like a 75% software problem and a 25% hardware problem. So we're doing everything we can to bring the community with us, but we're also bringing the open source community with us, and we're contributing on a number of projects there, including, you know, plugins for Unreal Engine, Blender, Audacity, GIMP, and OBS as examples. But these are also great software examples that other ISVs can delve into, just grab examples and leverage bits of code. And then another piece we've been working on, and it's out there and it's working, we've got this demonstrable, very high performance stable diffusion. We're actually open sourcing this as a plugin for GIMP. So then just wrapping back around. So what's the Intel advantage in this space? So fundamentally, we've got massive hardware scale. So there's going to be hundreds of millions of these platforms, all with this AI acceleration at low power. It launches later this year, right? But back to that point, right? 75% of this is software. So we have this massive x86 app ecosystem, and we're going to bring that with us, and we're letting our ecosystem enhance their apps and leverage the low power acceleration through our seamless tools and flows. And then, you know, enabling even more of those workflows and new experiences as we move forwards. So, you know, just to wrap up with the bottom line, Intel's super well positioned to sort of turn this corner as the PC really starts to transform again and we transform the PC user experience.